Some people call me the space cowboy. Yeah. Some call me the gangster of love. Some people call me Maurice. Cause I speak of the pompousness of love. People talk about me, baby.
Team like Aldershot.
Well, I thought they deserved it. They had to prove to me, the club had to prove to me that they were up to it, and they did it very well. They deserved it, and football in general deserved it.
In June, Spencer Trithewey told Coast to Coast he was a millionaire property dealer owning several companies. But former colleagues say he's been living in a world of dreams and fantasies.
Play my music in the sun. I'm a joker.
Later, Shot's goalkeeper John Grandall handled outside his area. The referee sent him off. Red card number two came in the second half when skipper Charlie Henry made a goal-saving tackle. Referee Ray Bigger warned it was a deliberate foul and gave a penalty.
Two after his team were also down and beaten after a mix-up in defence. The final score, Chesterfield 2, Aldershot 1.
36th minute, Heron scored the only goal of the game. Peter Heritage beat Aldershot keeper John Grandall.
Ryan Talbot, Aldershot's manager and managing director, has transfer listed his team to G them up, he says. But why does he carry on?
My wife often tells me, what on earth are you doing down there? I love it. I love every minute I'm here. I wake up in the morning, look forward to coming to work. I don't feel any pressure. The last job I was in, which I got sacked from the FA Cup last year, when Wogan beat me, in the finish I didn't enjoy my job. But here, I'm going to honestly say, we have no money. We were training in a park this morning. I've done a deal for boots and for balls and all these little things we haven't got, and I love it.
This is the game that should have shooed the wolf from Aldershot's door. But FA Cup defeat at the hands of non-league Enfield denied them income from a cup run and extended a streak that now stands at 13 games without a win.
I've had enough. I am walking out, if that's the right word, or leaving today, knowing that I've done my best. I think the club is in a healthier state because it was a crusade, really, to pay the bills and survive.
A battery of cameras welcomed the Aldershot team onto the pitch. A crowd of almost 3,000 in the ground. For the players, a chance to sign off with a rare win, although their defence lived dangerously early on. But in the second half, Aldershot went so close to a deserved victory. David Puckett's shot on the run, slipping the bar. And there was no lack of commitment. This jarring tackle from Mark Rees showed the players hadn't given up. At the end, they were mobbed off the pitch. With no pay for almost 7 weeks, just how much longer can they carry on?
Desperate for surprise. Want somebody to come in one day and surprise us by saying, here's all your wages that we owe you, and the club saying, and all the talk does nothing for us anymore. They did it for us, but to be fair, we've got a bit blasé about all the talk.
How much longer can you go on without being paid, though?
I'm struggling now with it. I'm plenty of fire.
Still checking with his wristwatch. He's given us full value for money tonight. And what could be Aldershot's final game of their league career? Because the final whistle goes here at Indian Park. It's Cardiff City 2, Aldershot 0. And we'll watch the Aldershot players leave the pitch and take their bows there from the gallant band of Aldershot supporters who followed them thick and thin, particularly this season, the most traumatic in their history. They are out of business at the moment. They are hoping for a last gasp saviour to keep them going. And even as we speak, we have no idea whether Aldershot Football Club will be in business
in the next couple of days. But there they are, taking the plaudits from their supporters. They battle hard, they battle well. And remember, most of them are part-timers. They haven't been paid since the Christmas period.
Okay.